Let's move farther north in our story about wetlands and migration. The Pacific Rim has another important migratory species as well, and Erin is going to tell us about that. Erin?
Well, hello, Panama. I'm up here on the Chugach National Forest in Alaska to talk about our next wetland connection. You've seen how hammerhead sharks are connected through a healthy system of wetlands in the tropics, and we've also learned about shorebirds and how they migrate from Panama to Alaska through a chain of wetlands. So now let's learn about how salmon need a healthy system of wetlands across their range. Pacific salmon could once be found from California all around the Pacific Rim to Japan and China. Salmon start their lives in streams and lakes and then travel to oceans to become adults. They return to the streams, like this one right here, where they were hatched to lay their own eggs. So most salmon return to the same stream where they were hatched, but some stray to other streams. And salmon have this one special adaptation that helps them maintain healthy populations. In some years, some streams have low water or other obstacles, and having the ability to travel to other streams is important to keep salmon populations healthy. With wetland restoration happening in areas with salmon habitat, this trait enables salmon to move back into areas where they haven't lived in 50 years. Salmon bring nutrients into the watershed and help restore other plants and animal populations. So that is why it is important to have a healthy chain of streams, lakes, and estuaries for salmon throughout their range.